A man charged with killing a Kansas City journalist is now confessing to a string of burglaries. The 20-year-old says he hit several homes within this small area of the Ruskin Heights neighborhood. But this is only the start. KMBC 9's Martin Augustine has this story live tonight. Martin?
Larry, Antonio Grandison is charged with the murder of Nick Dutcher, who was an assignment editor at KSHB-TV. He formerly worked as an assignment editor here with us at Channel 9. According to these court documents filed just today, a few weeks ago, detectives here at the Kansas City Police Department's South Patrol headquarters got the word that Grandison had something to tell them.
Court papers say Grandison wanted to confess to several burglaries, all but one in the Ruskin Heights area. Here's where those burglaries happened. Note how close each one is to the other, some happening this year, one dating back a couple of years. Detectives drove Grandison around this neighborhood, and not only did he point out the specific homes he hit, he also remembered the specifics of what he stole.
It was bad.
Rick Ruth is a victim of one of those crimes. His home actually hit three nights in a row.
My two boys felt it worst. They, like you said, they felt devastated. Violated is a good word for it.
There's something else in these court documents, too. Besides the homes that Grandison pointed out to police as they were driving around this neighborhood and detailing all the things that he'd stolen from those homes, Grandison also says in these documents that he told police that there were probably 50 other homes throughout the Kansas City area that he'd broken into over the last couple of years.
Indeed, the night Nick Dutcher was killed, his home had been burglarized. Court records telling us that Dutcher came home to find the burglar inside. A struggle broke out. Nick was strangled. Court records say Grandison confessed to it. He's entered a not guilty plea in court.
It doesn't surprise me that they've keep advancing.
Rick Ruth, worrying that burglars are becoming more violent, wonders how and if the sort of thing Grandison is accused of will ever stop.
Now, in those court papers, Grandison confessed to one other burglary that was not in the Ruskin Heights area. It happened around 128th and State Line, which is not very far away from where Grandison's father lives, according to those court papers. Reporting live, Martin Augustine, KMBC 9 News. Larry?
So, Martin, when is Grandison back in court for the murder charge?
He's set to go back on October 21st. At that time, a trial date is expected to be set on that murder charge.
Martin Augustine, thank you very much. The prosecutor wants Grandison's bond for the burglary charges to be set at $250,000.